Hello, everyone, and welcome to DCA Takedown, episode 74. I'm MTB the HKK here with V-Pac and Brian Henniger. And guys, we got a hell of a show here tonight.
I am Brian Henniger, and I'm here with MTV and V-Pac. As you heard earlier, we have a world title match tonight. We got a big tag team match open up the table.
Yeah, here come the former DCA World Tag Team Champions. Aaron Alexander up on the left with the hood, and the big rig Mark Austin on the right. And I swear his beard has gotten twice as long since the last time we saw him.
Indeed, he's definitely a big and powerful individual. As well as his partner.
And of course, the Blacklist looking to get back into the tag team title hunt after they lost those titles to Future Foundation a few weeks ago here on Takedown. But nonetheless, guys, the Blacklist is going to have their hands full here tonight on Takedown. Because look who they're facing.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. They are the label, not the stable. Blackout 2.0, Little Jazz, and the freak of nature, and I mean that in a good way, Gorilla Black.
Or as I like to call him, the man that defies all physics.
Or as Ahaya calls him, oh God! I'm sorry, I shouldn't make fun of Ahaya when he's not here. It's much more fun to mock him to his face. But nonetheless, Gorilla Black and his partner all set for action here tonight. Blackout 2.0 unsuccessful at capturing the tag titles at Redemption and seeking redemption tonight.
Yeah, Wait, look at... Oh, what a move that was there by Gorilla Black.
The man that physics forgot. Whoa!
Well, guys, I'm going to tell you something. You know, we talk about these amazing athletes. Gorilla Black is in a class by himself. And people, if you've never seen this man wrestle, you are in for an absolute treat. He is, actually, his nickname is he's the world's strongest man that gravity forgot, Gorilla Black. About 6 feet six feet seven, 350 pounds with legs like tree trunks, but he's got amazing agility for a man of his size.
Uh-oh, look at this.
Yeah, you have to see to believe, ladies and gentlemen.
You owe somebody I know 5 cents for that move.
Little Jazz now in the ring with Mark Austin. Oh! That body drop there by the big rig as the tag is made. Here comes the franchise, Aaron Alexander.
Aaron Alexander, one of the tougher men in this business. The guy who is, well, the Blacklist, one of the most exciting tag teams in all of virtual wrestling, have not really been on a tear lately, but these guys are still in that upper echelon. And, you know, I'll say this, with the tag team division being as wide open as it is here in the DCA, with so many amazing tag teams, you know, the old expression is it's an embarrassment of riches. But I think that makes the competition even more challenging because you've got to do a lot just to stay lost in the shuffle. And a rookie mistake right here from Little Jazz.
Ooh, what kind of idiot goes up into the opponent's corner looking for something?
That's a very good question.
Well, in any case, guys, getting back to the Blacklist for a second, now that their spiritual leader, pretty much Casey Gordon, is back, Do you think there's a chance that the Blacklist could ever achieve the former glory they had here at DCA?
It's possible, V-Pac. Anything's possible with the right motivation.
Only it's a little jazz now.
Look at this. Neck breaker!
Yeah, thank God Zahai is not here to do the repeat of that.
Exactly. Now rear chin lock.
It kind of looked like he was raking the eyes there for a little bit there, Brian.
Yeah, you're right. I think I saw the fingers go up a little bit up the facial area. But little Jazz able to take advantage, and now he is in the driver's seat in the early goings of this contest.
Yeah, yes. Little Jazz taking it to the former world champion.
Nonetheless, Aaron Alexander.
The ropes. Into the face buster.
Brian, as you and Jim Ross like to say, it takes two incredible it takes a good singles competitor to be a good tag team competitor. We are seeing two of the toughest singles competitors teaming up here tonight.
Exactly, and you guys have got to look at the classic of tag team wrestling. Oh, wait a minute. He's put on the top rope. Could be the most overused move in virtual wrestling.
Superflex all the way.
Wait. Oh. That could have been really
little
bad.
Jazz
for little
Jazz dodged a bullet. Almost had an El Generico style brainbuster.
Yeah.
But did he ever dodge a bullet there?
That was a close one.
Oh, look at this. 300 pounds on the shoulders of little Jazz.
Electric chair face buster.
I don't know who this El Generico is, but I'm a huge Sami Zayn fan.
El Generico retired to Mexico and he's helping orphans.
That's always good. Now, the big rig Mark Austin, as I said, 7 feet tall, 300 pounds of spring steel and raw hide. Got him out of the cover.
Two and no.
Little Jazz needs to tag in the freak of nature known as Gorilla Black, the world's strongest man that gravity forgot. The physics to fire. I don't think Little Jazz is going to do that because only smart people do that.
You were saying, MTV?
Oh, look at that. He used his brain.
And now Gorilla Black in it. Oh, my
God! Now we got a show on our hands.
Powerbomb neckbreaker combination with Blackout 2.0. 2-0.
One of the most... Now look at this. Oh, my God! Springboard into
brilliant.
An elbow drop by the 350-pound Gorilla Black.
Jesus. Like I said, it's you have to see to believe.
And, oh, a huge senton drop.
And you know, MTB, you do realize that Blackout 2.0 is from Battle Pro. You know who else comes from Battle Pro?
Wait, you're not talking about the great Malik Brown, are you?
Yes.
The man, exactly. The myth, the legend, the greatest thing to ever set foot in a wrestling ring? My lord! Well, every league has one mistake. Just ask Stanley Smallwood.
Now.
Wow, wait, what is this? What is this? Was Black up
Gorilla Black,
here?
He's got him up and... Oh my God!
Wow!
Leaps through the ropes to do a tornado DDT on to the big rig Mark Austin. You know, as they said of the late great Christopher Reeve, you will believe a man can fly.
Look at this. Oh! Running senton from Gorilla Black. Well, nonetheless, I may owe Malik an apology for the insults about Little Jazz, but...
Little Jazz got him some fight in him. He's an amazing wrestler. Oh, but now a hip toss onto Gorilla Black.
Tag is made now. Aaron Alexander's in. Almost like a neck breaker on the knee. Oh, God!
You know, I had the great pleasure of interviewing Gorilla
Press. Shooting Star Press.
You know, guys, not to change the subject here, but I had the great pleasure of interviewing Gorilla Black a few weeks ago for an interview, and he is one of the most complex individuals you will ever talk to. And a two count, you know, just to talk about how he came up, started out working at a blimpy sandwich shop, and then went to Battle Pro with his longtime partner, Little Jazz, how they have just managed to really gel as a tag team, and how they're becoming, in my mind, one of the best tag teams in the business.
Without a doubt, the combination of Little Jazz and... Sorry about that, my mic got cut out there. Like I was saying, the combination of Little Jazz and Gorilla Black is absolutely impressive. Almost won the tag team titles of Redemption.
Exactly. Yeah, if you notice in the corner there, you probably saw the big rig Mark Austin kind of slumping over the corner. It's obvious he's heavily fatigued in this opening bout. And guys, this is just our opening contest.
Uh-oh, here we go. Oh, wow.
Bicycle kick into a splash.
Good night, Irene.
Here's the cover. One, two, no. Gorilla Black breaks it up.
Oh, but look at this. Gorilla Black taking down the big man. Lil Jazz starting to stir. This is an opportunity to make a tag to his partner. Whoa, quick roll away.
No, instead, Lil Jazz getting sent to the corner of the Blacklist. Tag is made. Here comes Aaron Alexander.
Oh, Lewis. Oh, with the double elbows.
Now, quick lateral press. Covers him one.
One, two, no. Kick out at two. Aaron Alexander couldn't get the pin that time. But you have to think.
No one.
And now, Mark Austin says Gorilla Black the outside. There you see Little Jazz trying to get the crowd rally behind him.
And oh, kick to the midsection. Oh, he could be a move, guys. He calls this move, if he's going to hit it, he calls it Welcome to Jamrock.
Whoa! Reminds me of a suicidal plunge, but nonetheless, look at this with the cover. One, two.
Oh, only a two count. Kind of puts me in the mind of Gregory Helms with the vertebraker.
That's true.
Whatever happened to that guy? Is he still with Impact?
No,
I have no idea.
He just quit, actually.
Oh, good for him.
Yes, Gregory Helms is not going to get busted things anytime soon.
Well, I say bigger and better things, but in the Impact case, at least it's going to be bigger things. Anyway, cover one, two.
And no, again, Aaron Alexander kicks out at two.
Look at this. Oh, with the huge elbow drop, leaping into the air like a leopard.
I don't think he got all of it, though.
He didn't really, but you know, when I look at Gorilla Black, he really reminds me of a young big boss man, Ray Traylor, with that uncanny speed and agility for a man of his size.
But the way he moves in the ring, he looks like Bam Bam Bigelow decided to take lessons from Adrian Neville.
You ain't wrong, MTB. Oh, elbow. And guys, this is only our opening contest tonight. We've still got that humongous world heavyweight title match coming up later in the evening.
Look at this spine buster.
Spine on the pine by Aaron Alexander, the franchise, as he calls himself, in a spear.
Instantly taking him down. And no, there's the kick out. Uh-oh, the Gorilla Black, he's far from finished. Oh!
Oh, jawbreaker.
And now Aaron Alexander, what's this?
Oh! Jackhammer!
A thunderous jackhammer on a Gorilla Black. Here's the cover. Two, and no.
Good Lord. The resiliency of Gorilla Black is impressive.
Guys, you got to ask yourself, what is it going to take to put one of these two teams away?
It's going to take one of them having bigger balls than the other, Brian.
You mean you may need an Abrams tank to put one of them away?
Or park a bus on them. Wait, what's this?
Oh!
Gutbuster.
Single knee gutbuster by the franchise, Aaron Alexander.
Oh, inside cradle.
This could do it. One,
no.
Two, no.
Aaron Alexander now, what's he looking to do? Irish whip. Over the ropes goes Gorilla Black.
And if you noticed, the big rig kind of held the ropes down a little bit for him.
Uh-oh.
And now,
big rig.
Clearly, this match is taking its toll on all four men.
Yeah, all four men heavily fatigued, as you can tell. And now that he tarried a bit there. That might have been a humongous mistake. And look at this. Guillotines him right across the second ring rope right in front of his tag team partner. That's some psychological warfare right there, gentlemen.
Oh! A little shake, rattle, and roll. Showing a little bit of the American dream, Dusty Rhodes right there from the big man.
If you will.
That was pandemonium in the aisle, Brian.
They'd be
as
a big
rig. He goes for the big move. Oh, my Lord. One, two.
Only gets a two count.
Yeah, again, only two out of that. I believe that was a show 10.
Oh, wait, I see some red, guys. You know what I got to say?
Go ahead.
We got a bleeder.
Big time busted open. Is the big rig.
Absolutely, and now look at this. Oh!
Oh! Gorilla Black, I'm not sure he has anything left in him.
Yeah, his strength has been sapped.
You can see he's on spaghetti legs right now.
Exactly, he's on Dream Street right now, and Mark Austin needs to take advantage, as does Aaron Alexander.
This could be their opportunity.
That's some amazing double team. Wait a minute.
Gorilla Black may have found his second win.
He may have. He popped right up.
Whoa!
Humongous splash, and now Snake Eyes right into the sick, you know, the top turnbuckle, and a humongous, oh my gosh. Some incredible combinations there from the otherworldly Gregory Black.
Uh-oh, look at this. Once again, taking it paid from the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, with the bionic elbows back to back to back.
And I apologize. I said Gregory Black. I should have said Gorilla Black, but you know something? That amazing athletic ability reminds me of Gregory Black. He's going to fly. No, he's not.
Oh! May have done more harm than good. Gorilla Black land right on top of his partner.
Exactly. And I'll say this, guys. You know what? If we keep seeing the kind of performance from Gorilla Black we're seeing now, he might be seen as a Gorilla Black level singles competitor, should he ever want to do it.
Now look at this though. Massive clubbing blow to the back of Aaron Alexander by Gorilla Black.
We can certainly see Gorilla Black having a future as a world champion if he keeps up this level of talent. But look at this, the stomps in the corner and the tag to Little Jazz.
Oh, they're stomping a mud hole into the franchise. Another tag.
Frequent tags between,
Oh, a drop kick from Little Jazz.
He Irish whipped him with all of his strength right into the franchise.
One, two, no.
Only a two count.
How close was that, guys?
About a millimeter away, and uh-oh.
Dodging the spear, little jazz. Oh!
Oh, counter there by Aaron Alexander.
And now Aaron Alexander, he's laying in wait for little jazz. He runs in. Oh!
A massive spear! A thunderous spear!
He got all of that one, guys, but he's in the corner.
Now cover one, two, no.
Ooh, only two, only two. Set out drop kick, and all four of these men heavily fatigued. As you can see, Gorilla Black sort of slumping over in the corner, as is the big rig Mark Austin. Both men trying to recover some of that lost wind in this tag team encounter.
You can clearly tell that fatigue is starting to set in on all four men here.
The Blackout 2.0 need probably in order to get in this contest is maybe a little bit of extra motivation, just like the Blacklist has. They're from the same promotion as Malik Brown. Maybe they should join the NIS. And oh!
That same combination.
And look at this, Lil Jazz trying to get back into this match.
And look. Again, could be the greedy, could be. Welcome to Jam Town.
Jam Rock.
Jam Rock, whatever.
And he got it. He got it.
Got all of it, too. Covers him
one.
Is it going to be enough this time? It is. It is all over.
Game, set,
match. What a way to kick off Takedown 74.
Eight freaking men. What an amazing opening contest for this great show.
Blackout 2.0, despite the loss at Redemption and the failed attempt to get the tag titles for Future Foundation, they seem to be back on track.
They're on point, as they say.
Thought this might have been over earlier with the powerbomb neck breaker combo. There was no such luck. Blacklist, not exactly game.
Oh, no, look at that.
Yes.
An amazing standing shooting star press. This guy is almost from another, he's otherworldly with his agility and his strength combination. That's just how amazing this man is.
At the end of the day, it was Jamtown that put away Big Rig for the pin.
Guys, that is all she wrote, and I'll say it, if they can put together some more victories like that, you could be looking at your next DCA World Tag Team Champions. You've got to think that they have got a championship opportunity in the very near future, gentlemen.
Without a shadow of a doubt, Blackout 2.0, impressive here tonight.
Absolutely. And guys, we are just getting started. Let's go to the back.
Well, guys, here we go with our next matchup.
Yeah, that's right, that's right. Ladies and gentlemen, what begins tonight is going to be a best of seven series between our next two gentlemen that are about to face off here tonight.
We know all about this guy. The man, the myth, the legend, the one.
Kerry Roberts.
Yeah, Kerry Roberts. Looking to make a name for himself here, and this is how you do it. You do it in the ring, and comes out. He looks like he's ready to wrestle.
Unless
we can't forget the controversy between Kerry Roberts and the man he abandoned in a tag team match last time on Takedown. Which leads us to this best of seven.
Exactly. This is how you determine the best around. And here comes the man he'll face for at least four matches.
Yeah, this is Chris Douglas, I believe.
It is Chris Douglas. He is an amazing wrestler.
And of course, a huge prize awaits the winner of this best of seven series. Of course, that being a shot at the DCA Pure Championship.
Absolutely.
Of course, whoever wins that 16-man elimination tournament to crown the inaugural Pure Champions.
Indeed, with such wondrous superstars such as Daniel Stone and Dante Styles in that tournament, you gotta wonder
exactly.
That both of these men
really
better be ready.
Really?
well, bell sounds are underway, gentlemen. I gotta ask you a question here.
Let's not forget who else is in the tournament. We got the Christopher the Saint Samuels.
Exactly. And now, spinning toe hold on the Gary Rock. Sorry, what's this guy's name again? The man in the red?
Kerry Roberts.
Kerry Roberts.
Well, I thought Gary Roberts. I want to get these names right.
Kerry Roberts. That's his name.
That's right, and he's taking on Chris Douglas right now, an impressive technician in his own right. I'll never forget the match that he had with Caden Monroe, the violent artiste, during the Redemption pre-show. I called that match by myself, and it was absolutely impressive to see him pull that match off. Look at this. Oh, Kerry Roberts with a huge back suplex to Chris Douglas.
Those of you who want to make sure that you keeping track of everybody, Kerry Roberts, the man who is in the red trunks, Chris Douglas in the black trunks. If you have a black and white TV, for the love of God, buy a color TV.
I seriously doubt anybody that has a black and white TV these days.
Probably some hipster who's trying to just think he's better than everybody else. You never know anymore. And now,
just ask Sahaya. He has a black and white TV.
Well, anyway, a somersault into a DDT there by Chris Douglas.
When I asked Sahaya why he has a black and white TV, he said it matches his blinds.
Well, of course,
but nonetheless, look at this, Kerry Roberts. Oh! Look at that with a burning hammer.
And speaking of which, MTV, isn't there something we should be plugging right about now?
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Every Friday, you can catch a new episode of the hottest thing on the internet, Zahaya's Angels, featuring the internet's newest superstar, Mr. Zahaya Morgan. Where the Angels try to assist Mr. Zahaya Morgan with his love life.
And yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is in fact a thing.
It is a thing that exists, and you can watch it And now Kerry Roberts, lateral press, hook of the leg, cover two, and only a two count.
And only a two count.
Now, one question I want to ask you with this, you know, we do have the, we have the tournament coming up to crown the first ever Pure Champion. These two men are fighting for a number one contendership spot. Has it been explained why these two weren't in the tournament to begin with?
Actually, Kerry Roberts was in a qualifying match for that for the Pure Title Tournament, and he ended up losing to AJ Young.
Right. Wasn't Chris? I'm not sure. I don't remember if Chris Douglas was in the qualifier either. I do believe he was, but he lost as well.
Yeah, Chris Douglas lost 1-2. I've been told.
Okay, so like their second chance.
Yeah, these two were in the last chance battle royal that was won by Tyler Parks, of all people.
Brilliant!
And during that entire match, these two just went head-to-head with each other. So management decided to book them in the best-of-seven series to determine who will get the first shot at the Pure title.
All right. Well, that's good. I'm glad that that's understandable. Thank you very much.
Which, according to, if everything goes according to plan, hopefully will be Christopher the St. Samuels as the Pure champion.
He has to make it through Dante Styles first, my friend. And now a cover. Well, actually, if he can even make it to Dante Styles, because let's not forget, Christopher the St. Samuels may eventually have to cross paths with the new TPGW World Champion, the All-American Outlaw, Daniel Stone. Don't forget to catch Hawaiian Beach Bash, folks, July 16th. Oh, and a drop kick from Kerry Roberts.
Yeah, also, MTV, the DCA stars are facing the DCA stars, and the outside talent's facing the outside talent, so Christopher St. Samuels isn't even going to fight Dante Styles.
Unless they both make the finals.
Exactly.
Which was my point, V-Puck.
Anyway, want to point this out, guys. So, well, if we're seeing an amazing technical matchup here. So I'll say this. The management here at DCA, they do get some things right. Of course, the Oslo Attempted Murderers compete for the Fever Championship. But, hey, you know, nobody's perfect, aren't they?
No, Lewis. Oh, wow. A huge
release regalplex there from Chris Douglas.
A T-bone suplex, and now look at this, a cravat.
Oh god, ow. Ow. Ooh. Ow.
Powerful cravat right here.
Fujiwara
ow.
From the innovator of technical prowess, Mr. Chris Douglas. Look at this.
Oh, look at that. Brainbuster there from Kerry Roberts. Shades of Tomohiro Ishii. Here's the cover.
One, two, no.
The Stone Pitbull himself.
By the way, as of this recording, congratulations to Tomohiro Ishii for making it to the semifinals in the IWGP US title tournament.
One of the finest, and now...
Oh, this is Kerry Roberts.
Oh!
Another one! And now, just wrenching on the neck of Chris Douglas. Douglas in a lot of trouble here.
And now a choke there from Kerry Roberts.
Now look at this reversal from Chris Douglas. Kerry Roberts with a quick uppercut.
Yeah, a huge uppercut there. Now what's this?
Uh-oh, reversal. Oh, reversal. Look at that perfect bridge.
Into a free bridge.
Two, and I think Rathburn Sally was completely out of position for that.
Yep.
Good thing the highest down here in a bitch. But Brian, it's... I believe you have something you want to say.
We got a bleeder!
We got a bleeder.
Look at this! Just stomping down on the wrist.
And now Kerry Roberts, he's got Chris Douglas back up, and he threw him into the corner. This right here, gentlemen, is what makes professional wrestling so much fun for me. The back and forth of these two. Oh, armbreaker onto Chris Douglas.
Now, Kerry Roberts maybe looking to end this thing, guys.
Roberts down. I don't know what he was going for. It was blocked by Douglas.
Right, Douglas sliding out of it. Kerry Roberts trying to get back on the offensive. Sending up to the top rope, but there's the reversal. And Chris Douglas off the ropes. Wow!
Flying elbow right to the face of Kerry Roberts. But Roberts is back up. Snapmare takeover. And a huge elbow to the top of the head.
Now the cover.
Cover, hook of the leg. One. Cover, two. Could be enough. No.
That flying elbow.
You'll notice, guys, Chris Douglas targeting the head of Kerry after he's wounded him. So you know he sees a bullseye on his skull.
That's right. That flying elbow reminiscent of Mr. Macho Man Randy Savage. Ooh, yeah. And now Kerry off Roberts. The ropes. Whoa.
Springboard. Oh, went for the springboard. Missing dropkick and missed. Oh,
and look at the headbutts! This is the vicious side of Chris Douglas I got to see at Redemption when he fought Caden Monroe.
Two,
that's it!
Three!
He headbutted him into submission. How impressive is that?
And with
impressive
that lead,
and dangerous, and he is going to be your first winner of your of this best of seven series. He goes up 1-0.
The score 1-0 now for Chris Douglas. I think Kerry Roberts would want to get that head checked out. Get his head checked out after those vicious headbutts. Oh, God. We don't want him ending up like Shibata now, do we?
Probably not. My question is, why wasn't Caden Monroe in this match? He was just as impressive, and he had a qualifier as well, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, against your favorite.
That's
Dante
right.
Dante Styles.
That's right. Dante Styles impressively put Caden Monroe away, but Caden Monroe has a pinfall victory over Chris Douglas, so why isn't he in this match? Well, nonetheless,
it remains to be seen. Anyway, hook of the leg, and that did not put away Chris Douglas. And you'll notice again,
this headbutt. Kerry Roberts away. Those headbutts literally knocking Kerry Roberts out. There you see 2 and 3. Chris Douglas up 1-0.
And
the innovator of technical prowess, Chris Douglas, with a huge victory here tonight.
Well, to the victor go the spoils.
Show me how to lie, you're getting better all the time, and turning all against one is an art that's hard to teach. Another clever word sets off an unsuspecting hurt, and as you step back in the line, a mob jumps to their feet. Now dance, fucker, dance, man. He never had a chance, and no one even knew it was really only you. And now you steal away, take him out today. Nice work you did. You're gonna go fuck it with a thousand lies and a good disguise. Hit him right between the eyes. Hit him right between.
some very harsh words there from Tyson Jackson's manager. But in any case, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Our main event is up next.
That's right, V-Pac.
You'll get to see a World Heavyweight Championship match here on Takedown all that often, but that's what we're going to have tonight.
And it's going to be one for the ages, guys. I can promise you that.
Yep. Chris, the true chess master, Chris Knight, getting a DCA title shot.
What do you expect from Chris Knight? He's extremely talented.
Yeah, sure he is.
But he's not. I'd say he certainly does have a shot, but I got to put my money on my main man, Smokey, guys.
You know, Chris Knight had some harsh words to say a few days ago towards Smokey. Right now, it is put up or shut up time for the true chess master, in my personal opinion.
Yep.
Well, if anything,
I'm going to put aside what happened on PCW between me and Chris Knight for now and call this match down the middle.
Chris Knight, a sole survivor, a lone wanderer. Get the references to his tights.
He sure is.
But he's gonna
this
need...
is what he's gonna.
But now, guys, you know what it's time for?
Here comes the reigning DCA World Heavyweight Champion.
The reigning, defending, undisputed DCA World Heavyweight Champion. The man, the myth, the legend, the great Smokey.
Think he has enough names?
AMTV, I think you have something brown on your nose there.
Look at this brilliance. This and man took the great D to the limit. Virtual wrestling's last outlaw. The man who took the great D to the limit and put him away. The man who hasn't been given an opportunity that well in his career and now is finally taking a stand. You are looking at the man who is going to put away Chris Knight here tonight. Smokey has been proven that he is a dominant world champion. And my money has got to be on this man. The man has been winning all of his matches without help. V-Pac, or even though he's not here, is the hi-ya.
You gotta take him out or buy him a dress. Seriously.
And that brown thing on your nose just grew like 5 times in size.
Well, the referee with the title. Both these
that
men
is what
want
it's
an opportunity
all about,
at it.
Guys.
Yep, that's what it's all about.
My money is put has got to be on Smokey when this. Guys, my money has got to be on Smokey when this match, just like he's won every other, all by himself, just as the great Malik has. And here we go.
The bell is rung, and here we go with our main event.
Smokey versus Chris Knight. Takedown's main event, world title on the line. Both these men with the stare down and now the lockup.
You've got to think that Malik Brown is, sorry, not Malik Brown, you got to think that Chris Knight is nervous right now. He's got to be, you know, pretty amped up. This is a world, this is a chance to become the heavyweight champion of the world. So he's got to be ready for anything at this point. And he is a former world heavyweight champion, I do believe.
Nonetheless, Chris Knight is ready for a war. And war never changes, guys.
Well, let's not forget. Chris has been having issues with his family dealing with Ashura lately.
And look at this, Smokey reversing into a Fujiwara armbar.
let's hope he can put the situation with Ashura behind him, because this is for the world title.
Well, you know, he's a human being. He can't completely shut his brain off. He's going to be thinking about those kind of things, unfortunately. But you're right. He's going to have to find a way to block it from his mind if he wants to become the champion of the world.
Here comes... Oh, no!
Oh, look at that. Nice chop block there from Chris Knight.
Get up, champ. You're all right. You're taking worse hits than that.
Of course, I know exactly how Smokey feels right about now.
And here comes Smokey. Oh, no!
Cover here by Knight. What a quick rope break.
And look at this. Smokey now.
Vertical suplex there onto the true chess master.
A vertical what?
Vertical suplex.
Oh!
You know, I'll say this about Smokey. You know, we may not see eye to eye, but, you know, give the devil his due. He has proven himself on more than one occasion to be a formidable competitor in that ring. I'll say that about him.
He's not just formidable. He's brilliant. He is the man who took the great D to the limit and completely and utterly crushed his dreams at redemption, Brian. You are looking at the man who is going to do great things in the future. Not only as a world champion, but as a man.
Are you done being his cheerleader?
No. And let's not forget that Smokey has a match at Caught All-Stars 9 coming up against Ben Hitman.
Well, he can't be looking at that right now, because right now he's got to focus on this match with Chris Knight.
Smokey is always focused. That's the kind of champion he is. He takes his matches one day at a time.
It's cross, and Chris Knight got the harder part of it.
Next thing you're going to tell me on TV is Smokey takes his vitamins, drinks his milk, and eats his Wheaties.
Of course he does, kids, and he eats his vegetables, too. Make sure you do that as well. Brush your
teeth
as well.
He says his prayers every night, I'm sure.
For all the little smokesters out there, brother.
Now,
B-Pop, do you want the NIS to make you a target? Because Smokey can make that happen.
Please.
Folks, in the match of hand here, as Chris Knight starting to take control.
Oh, and a huge clothesline right there. Now the cover. One, two. And there's the kick out.
Nice kick out. Man. Close call there by Smokey.
Boy, in the stomp right there. Chris Knight trying to chop his way back into this match. Smokey's in trouble. Chris Knight, he's got it measured. Oh! But look at that! Like the genius that he is, Smokey! Catch him with a drop toe hold, and there's an impressive maneuver right there.
And by the way, this is the first time these two men have actually been facing off here.
That's true.
Yeah. So, I mean, both guys, obviously I've been watching a lot of game film, as you might say, about these two, but you know, you really can't compare to actually competing in the ring against your opponent. And now, oh, Chris Knight, lateral press.
This be it. No.
Smokey getting the shoulder up. Chess master.
That's right. Smokey fortunately getting the shoulder up. No, and there's a chop in the corner. Oh, what a snake eyes. And Smokey now. Uh-oh.
Collision in the ring there. And that has given Chris Knight an opening.
Chris Knight's far from finished. Uh-oh, look at this. Oh!
Yeah, it's definitely going to take a lot. Well, that's to put Chris Knight down.
Oh,
as again,
Smokey
goes back
down
to the chop block.
Come on, champ, get back up.
And now the rear chin lock being applied by Chris Knight.
Trying to wear down Smokey, apply the pressure. And here comes the champ.
Smokey back up to a vertical basis.
He stands on their feet, ready to see the champ put Chris Knight away.
That's your opinion, but right now, Chris Knight, though,
uh-oh,
he's not going down.
Look at this. Brilliant.
Sunset flip.
Into the cover.
One.
Two.
No.
Oh, only a two count. Chris Knight not going down that easily.
Uh-oh. Smokey's fired up, guys.
Now this working on the leg of the chess master. Look at that, though. Chris Knight fighting back with the European uppercut. And a huge chop across the chest.
You can't do that to the champ.
Yeah, pretty
well, he just did.
And I'm pretty sure that chop must have been intensified considering that Chris Knight's wearing gloves.
Now we'll cover one, two. No.
Again.
Chris Knight barely getting the shoulder up there.
And now Knight sending Smokey into the corner. Back elbow there by Smokey.
Oh!
Oh, I believe you have something to say, Brian.
We got another bleeder!
That just goes to show you how far Smokey's willing to take this, guys.
We got a bleeder.
Oh!
Oh, that running knee lift there by Chris Knight. And now, Knight on the top rope drops the elbow into the cover. One,
look out, champ.
Two, and it's the new champion. Good.
Good.
Oh, reverse knife edge chops.
Oh, shot with the knee. Smokey trying to get back into this.
Yeah, this series of right hands.
Throwing his way back in. That's what the champ does. Those strikes are lethal, guys. Go ahead and show off. Smokey's gonna put you in the shatterproof anytime now.
And yet you try to make it a big thing of Smokey taunts. Back body drop there by the champion.
He's the champ. He can taunt if he wants to.
Oh, knee drop.
Now the cover. One, two. Chris Knight.
That's all he's going to get, guys. Oh, and Smokey, little taunt there to Chris Knight.
Oh!
That's got a hold of him, a big lariat, and that takes him down.
Knight now in control, another one. Chris Knight taking it to Smokey. A third short arm lariat. He trying to be Okada here?
He did a spinning back fist.
Constant shots to Smokey. The champ may actually be in trouble, guys. With the cover. And no! How close was that, guys? Chris Knight is frustrated. He can't put the champ away.
And he cannot afford to get frustrated. He's just got to stay focused. Because the minute you lose that focus, that's how you lose matches. And now, got him in a cradle, too. Is that going to be enough here? No.
Look at this. Smokey going behind. No.
Now look at this. Oh, counter.
I got a hand to Chris Knight. He's been taking the champ move for move.
And only a one count by Chris Knight.
Just goes to show you what will win this match more, guys.
I don't know at this point.
Chris Knight's technical prowess or Smokey's resilience.
I gotta say, it's gonna come down to who wants it more. I think that's who it's gonna be. Who wants to be the champion more, ladies and gentlemen? That's gonna be the deciding factor. Now, Smokey!
With everything Smokey's been through in his life, everything he's been through in his career, with the cover here. One!
Yeah, top rope clothesline, two!
I gotta believe the champ wants it more, Brian. I gotta believe it.
You may be right about that.
And now,
Smokey.
Oh, what is this?
No!
Nice takedown there by the champion. This capacity crowd really getting into this matchup here. All of this though. He's back up.
In the clothesline. Oh, and a back body drop.
Chris Knight's filling up. Oh, humongous spine buster. I think Chris Knight's giving up on his technique. He's just laying as much leather as he can right now. He's not a lot of frustration here.
Oh, wait. Chris, could we go? He's telling Smokey to get up. Are we going to see it? No, Smokey counters. Big boot misses. Release German suplex.
Come on, champ, it ain't over yet.
And now look at this. Oh, my God. Look at the face of Chris Knight, guys.
As Mr. Esarch says, someone brought the Frigo.
They did.
Oh! Breaking the eyes right there. That's uncalled for. You can't rake the eyes of the champ. Referee needs to disqualify him for raking the eyes.
And yet if Smokey did it, you wouldn't have a problem with it now, would you?
Champ doesn't even resort to things like that. He's Smokey.
And now, Chris Knight, what's this? Drops him on his head with a pile driver.
Chris Knight now going for the cover, one. Oh no.
Wow, not even two, and Chris Knight's definitely starting to show some frustration here.
And as I'll say it again, guys, he can't afford to get frustrated. He's going to have to stay focused.
Wait, guys. Is he going to go for it? No. And he's going to go for something there. It was blocked. And a powerbomb attempt turned into an arm drag. And now, look at this.
He's having a single leg Boston Crab.
Was not able
to get all of it, though.
Yeah, calf crusher. Unfortunately, he couldn't get all of it.
Okay, reversing though.
You look tonight, just the blood trickling down his forehead. That's got to be him.
And again, countering the champ. Counter after counter after counter after counter.
So much this guy does is phenomenal. So much that this guy does beyond what he can do. Could be enough here, number one. Dude, he did it up.
How close was that, guys?
Well, they'll come much closer, ladies and gentlemen. And Chris Knight knew he was less than a second away from becoming a champion.
Uh-oh, Smokey, though.
And I noticed Smokey's been cut open as well. He's bleeding in addition.
Wait a minute, Smokey!
Whoa, wait!
He caught him!
Shatterproof. That could do it. Oh, wait, no, he's not done. Oh, he's going for a second one. Another shatterproof.
That's got to be it, guys. He's got to go over now.
Oh!
He's not done.
Oh, we've seen this from Smokey before, guys. This is how I put away the great thing.
Got him in a, was it an omoplata or is it a...
It's the outlaw lock.
Oh, man, this is what he used to, this is what he's used to put away his opponents. He beat TJ Kennedy with this move, and he beat the great D with it.
And with Chris Knight valiantly trying to fight it off.
Ah, this one's over.
They tapped, it's over.
I told you, no help at all, and Smokey comes out on top. That's the kind of man Smokey is. That's the kind of champion he is. He never gives up, and he always finds a way to win.
I must give him credit. I must, you know what? I must give him his props.
Yeah,
he defended the championship tonight, and he is still your DCA World Heavyweight Champion.
Chris Knight ran his mouth about the champ. However, at the end of the day, the only thing he became was Smokey's next victim.
Let's go back and take a look at some of the action during this matchup. There you see Chris Knight dropping Smokey with that pile driver. Unfortunately, it would not get him the three count.
Of course it wasn't. The resiliency of the champ was too great. And after hitting two shatterproofs, all it took was the outlaw lock, and this thing was said and done, guys.
Well, again, you may not like him, but he is your champion.
Who wouldn't like Smokey? He's the champion of champions. You think this is something? Just wait until he gets his hands on Ben Hitman and caught All-Stars 9.
Well, there's Smokey successfully.
Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
That's AJ Young!
AJ Young!
What's he doing here?
AJ Young had some choice words for the NIS, specifically Smokey, Emily Brown, and look at this, Young Disaster! And now,
Smokey's now. AJ Young pay for this.
Look at that, AJ Young with the DCA World title. We know what he wants. Could this be a glimpse into the future of DCA?
We can only hope, guys. We got to go for all of us, for all of you. Stay safe. We'll see you soon. Good night, everybody.
Booyaka!